because I'm here. This
welcome
is Foxy.
Welcome back, man.
It's sweater day, too. Kenny and I decided to wear sweaters today, too, because it is a little chilly outside.
No, we're kids.
Yeah. Enjoy that, soak up that sunshine. It's going to rain later today, they say. But,
they say, right.
Anyway, it's fall. Next week's a big week for all of Cleveland, for not even restaurants that I house. It's Cleveland Beer Week. Mm. So I wanted to, you know, portray the love for the brew and the craft of the beer, because Kenny, Great Lakes, Wayne, they've been brewing for so many years now. Mm-hmm. Great Lakes Dortmund Gold, the Christmas Ale seasonal thing that they do very well.
Christmas Ale. Mm.
It's in and around those local breweries, Market Garden. They're doing such a great job over there. It's such a corridor that, you know, next week, the 21st to the 26th is Cleveland Beer Week, and it ends up with a gala at the Galleria next Friday night called Brewzilla.
Mm-hmm.
5,000 people transcend into the Galleria for the culmination of the Cleveland Festival Beer Week. So every city's starting to do it. Believe it or not, Cleveland's been doing it a lot longer than any other city. LA is actually doing their second one. Cleveland's on their 9th, 10th, 11th now.
Yeah.
So we do mussels, we do clams.
One of the first. It's so much. It's an experience.
It
is. It's really fun.
Especially the way that the craft beers have come along now and they're taking their place in the industry as prominent as wine, as other beverages. So when I think of that, I think Cleveland, I think clam time. The weather outside is frightful, so not frightful, but it's starting to get a little chilly, so
a little nip in the air.
We've got a little bit of
Dawson.
We're gonna go Stephanie ingredients first. A little bit of olive oil, which is a good way to start. Some fresh tomatoes, you know. We're gonna blister those a little, Ken. So get the pan nice and hot, a little bit of salt and pepper.
Nice.
Just gonna blister the skins a little bit. Wayne, I've got mussels, I've got clams. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter if it's Giant Eagle, Heinen's, Dave's. They should be clean, they should smell of the ocean, they should be opaque, and they should be, you know, hand-picked through and selected. There's a little bit of a beard, a little bit of a hair follicle. You want to take off the clams and the mussels. They've been clean. You should smell just of the ocean, Steph.
And nice always and the rule, if they don't open up, don't force them,
if
right?
If they don't open up, do not force them.
And don't eat them, discard them.
And I think some of the thing with people, they do clams and mussels. When Kenny and I throw a big clam bake, it's clams on top of mussels, it's steamed open. The steam is actually the process that you need help with. So that actually helps gravitate the clams open. So if you don't have a lid at home because your pots and pans are old like mine and Lexi's, you can use some tin foil. Just take a little bit of tin foil out and we're gonna cover it up safely, obviously. Now you don't wanna let the kids come over and touch it, obviously, while we're doing this, but we're gonna submerge that and make a cover. So 3 to 5 minutes later, we're gonna check on those.
That looks like a Jiffy Pop.
Then. Not until then.
Remember those?
Jiffy Pop popcorn.
Jiffy Pop's the way to go.
They still make them.
It still is. It's one of those things. It's fresh, it's flavorful, it comes out, you know, perfect portion size. So
I think.
We've got clams, we've got some greens, some Brussels sprouts. It's that time of year again. We're gonna add a little bit of pancetta to that.
Oh, nice.
And we're just gonna stir in a little bit of bell pepper.
Oh, Rocco.
Coulis. And a little bit of our Great Lakes. It's Cleveland Beer Week. Dortmund or Gold.
Goodness.
Kenny, you say, why Dortmund or Gold as opposed to Christmas Ale or Elliott Ness or things of that nature? It's because I like the way it blends in nicely. I've been doing it for a long time, and it really comes together nicely in lager form. So,
how did you amaze me how you just went like that, threw everything together?
And I've been here since 8:30 this morning. That's one of those things. So we'll take a peek at our clams and our mussels again, nice and hot.
They're opening up.
They are a little bit, so we're going to add some.
There's one or two.
Elliott Ness. You know, you can overdo it with booze. You just want to make sure with beer or wine or liquor or things of that nature that you're cooking with, that you want to cook out all that good stuff, all that alcohol, so you really just have the flavor of the beer that's left. Mm-hmm. You know, Steph, the nice thing about beers, too, is it's got hops and barley and things of that nature. They're from the earth. They're one of the longest, oldest origin grains in the world, and they have so much flavor, and they're so beautiful, and it's truly one of the best things that we can do. Mm-hmm. So it's beer week, again, clams, mussels, all those good kind of things. When you're at the grocery store, ask your fishmonger, ask your purveyors, what's fresh fishmonger, what's seasonal fishmonger? 3 to 5 minutes later, our steamers are up. I've already sent Jen the recipe, so we're gonna have a little fun with that as we go on.
Okay.
On
and how's everything going in Charlotte?
Charlotte's good. You know, obviously Cleveland is my home. For everybody at home that wants to know, Cleveland is where I live. I reside in Rocky River and love it. Mm-hmm. Charlotte's a back and forth process now, and we're gonna hopefully be open in January.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll keep our fingers crossed.
It's the established, you know, Michael Simon did it. You know, for the chefs in Cleveland to be able to go out and about in another state now is truly my life's dreams that I've been working towards.
Well, it's so great because the people that visit that want to know where you're from, and then it does something great for Cleveland.
And I appreciate the fans, Fox 8, the support, the fact that logo's been up for almost over a decade now with you guys week to week, and you guys are family, so Go Browns, Sunday, go Browns. Packers.
Yeah.
We got to take one. Brandon Wheaton's got to come out and have a good game, and I think he can do it, Wayne. I'm a positive supporter of the team and what they're doing.
And the Cavaliers getting started as well.
I like. Yeah. We'll be down at a couple of the games. Obviously, Rocco's Section 110 is obviously fun. But the Horseshoe Casino, you know, Cleveland, again, I can't emphasize enough how much fun it is to talk
There's
to people.
Buzz in the city.
To go out and really enjoy what they're doing on a regional level.
Those are awesome.
So you guys are great in pink, too. Thank you. Life
Thank
is good.
You. Thank you. For breast cancer awareness.
That's it.
All right, well, we're going to dive into this, and we'll be right back. Stay close. Wow.